Dear viewers, Drishti IAS welcomes you to the new series of Simplified. Today's topic of discussion is Bill Representation Process. The dimensions we are going to cover are Introduction, Types of Bills, Process of Legislation for an Ordinary Bill, and Assent of President. So let's begin with a brief introduction first. The legislative procedure is described under Article 107 to 111 of the Indian Constitution. The basic function of Parliament is to make laws, amend them, or repeal them. The process of lawmaking or the legislative process in relation to Parliament may be defined as the process by which a legislative proposal brought before it is translated into the law of the land. All legislative proposals are brought before Parliament in the form of bills. A bill is a statute in draft form and cannot become law unless it has received the approval of both the Houses of Parliament and the assent of the President of India. Now let's discuss about the types of bills. First is ordinary bills. As per Articles 107 and 108 of the Indian Constitution, an ordinary bill is concerned with any matter other than financial subjects. An ordinary bill is introduced in either House of the Parliament. This bill is introduced by a minister or a private member. There is no recommendation of the President in the case of ordinary bills. Ordinary bill can be amended or rejected by Rajya Sabha and it can be detained by Rajya Sabha for a period of 6 months. After being passed by both the Houses of Parliament, it is presented to the President for his approval or assent under Article 111 of the Indian Constitution. There is a provision of joint sitting in case of ordinary bills. Next is money bills. Money bills are those bills which are concerned with financial matters like taxation, public expenditure, etc. These are those bills that contain provisions that deal with all or any of the matters specified in Article 110 of the Indian Constitution. This bill is presented only in Lok Sabha and introduced only by the minister. Money bill is introduced only after the President's recommendation. Article 110 further clarifies that in cases where a dispute arises over whether a bill is a money bill or not, the Lok Sabha Speaker's decision on the issue shall be considered final. This bill cannot be amended or rejected by Rajya Sabha. It can be detained by Rajya Sabha for the maximum period of 14 days. Money bill is then sent to the President for his approval only after being passed by the Lok Sabha. There is no provision of joint sitting in case of money bill. Next is financial bills. As per Article 117 of the Indian Constitution, financial bills are those bills which are concerned with financial matters but are different from money bills. Financial bills are further classified as financial bills categories A and B. Category A bills contain provisions dealing with any of the matters specified in sub-clause A to F of clause 1 of Article 110 of the Indian Constitution. And Category B, bills involve expenditure from the Consolidated Fund of India. Next is Constitution Amendment Bills. Article 368 of the Indian Constitution is concerned with the provisions of amendment of the Constitution. As per the procedure laid down in the Constitution, Constitution Amendment Bills can be of three types, viz. Requiring a simple majority for their passage in each house, requiring special majority for their passage in each house, that is, a majority of the total membership of a house, and by a majority of not less than 2/3 of the members of that house present and voting, Article 368. Requiring special majority for their passage and ratification by legislators of not less than 1/2 of the states, by resolutions to that effect passed by those legislators, provision to clause 2 of Article 368. A constitution amendment bill under Article 368 can be introduced either House of Parliament and has to be passed by each House by special majority. There is no provision of joint sittings on a money bill or a constitution amending bill. Lastly, ordinance replacing bill. This bill is brought before Parliament to replace an ordinance with or without modifications promulgated by the President under Article 123 of the Indian Constitution. Now let's discuss the process of legislation for an ordinary bill. In first house, first reading. The ordinary bill can be introduced in either house by a minister or other member. Upon grant of leave by house, the member reads the title and objectives, but no discussion happens on this bill at this stage. Following this, the bill is published in Gazette. Second reading. At this stage, the detailed scrutiny of the bill happens and the bill takes full. It has three sub-stages. First is stage of general discussion. The principles of the bill and its provisions are discussed generally, but the details of the bill are not discussed. Second stage is committee stage. The usual practice is to refer the bill to a select committee of the House. This committee examines the bill thoroughly and in detail, clause by clause. It can also amend its provisions, but without altering the principles underlying it. After completing the scrutiny and discussion, the committee reports the bill back to the House. Next stage is consideration stage. The House, after receiving the bill from the select committee, considers the provisions of the bill clause by clause. Each clause is discussed and voted upon separately. The members can also move amendments, and if accepted, they become part of the bill. Third reading. No amendments are allowed anymore, and either bill is completely accepted, or if the majority accepts, it is passed and transmitted to the second house. Now in second house, bill goes through all three stages and house may pass the bill as sent by the first house, that is without amendments, or pass the bill with amendments and return it to the first house for reconsideration, or reject the bill altogether, or not take any action and thus keep the bill pending up to 6 months. If the second house passes the bill without any amendments, or the first house accepts the amendments suggested by the second house, the bill is deemed to have been passed by both the houses and the same is sent to the President for his assent. On the other hand, if the first house rejects the amendments suggested by the second house, or the second house rejects the bill altogether, or the second house does not take any action for 6 months, a deadlock is deemed to have taken place. To resolve such a deadlock, the President can summon a joint sitting of the two houses. Now moving on to the joint sitting. If the majority of the members present and voting in the joint sitting approves the bill is deemed to have been passed by both the houses. Not all bills can be referred to a joint sitting of the Parliament. There are two exceptions. Money bill under Article 110 and Constitution Amendment Bill under Article 368. Now lastly, let's discuss the assent of President. Every bill after being passed by both Houses of Parliament, either singly or at a joint sitting, is presented to the President for his assent. There are three alternatives before the President. He may give his assent to the bill, or he may withhold his assent to the bill, or he may return the bill for reconsideration of the Houses. If the President gives his assent to the bill becomes an act and is placed on the statute book. If the President withholds his assent to the bill, it ends and does not become an act. And if the President returns the bill for reconsideration, and if it is passed by both the houses, again with or without amendments, and presented to the President for his assent, the President must give his assent to the bill. Thus, the President enjoys only a suspensive veto. So that's all for today. Stay tuned for the next episode. Thanks for watching.